I mean, we know Shatta Wale, the pranks and, you know, this publicity stunts and all of that, but did you for once think he was going to pull this?
Tough one.
I
think so. We all forgot, not all of us, I think some of us forgot about the prophecy that came. About that, from that prophet that said he would be shot on that particular day. So I think I saw a post on socials that, oh, this is the time, Shatta Wale, whatever, whatever. Then I said, oh, that thing said, it's not going to happen. But it never crossed anybody's mind. Even in my office, we were actually arguing, because I was telling them that, oh, this is unfinished, because, I mean, the thing, it not happen. So at the corner, you see, so there's no need for him to do anything around the said prophecy. Only for us, some few hours later, only for the bus, you know, to start. When the bus began, I didn't believe it. I actually told the team nobody should do the story because it's not true.
Okay.
We actually tried to reach out to camp of Shatta Wale, and they were all saying they're not going to talk. And we tried to also find out from people around the SM movement. And Obiase, I think one guy even said he hasn't seen the king yet, so he cannot say it's true or not. But I told them that they should just ignore it. It's one of those things. I feel that he should have just ignored the whole prophecy thing. The thing didn't happen. You were not shot. You're fine. You're okay. Move on with your life. You're about to release a four-track chaff of the album. So just move on. You get it? But, I mean, like anyone said, it's Shatta Wale. He has to do something, you know, to make mockery of the said prophecy. But I think he pulled the wrong break.